out here. Wow. That's why you have electric. Alright, so I'm on the C470 trail now, heading towards the lake that I want to go to. I'm trying to keep my speed about 15 miles an hour so I don't wear out my battery. So, but I'll go downhill a lot faster, of course. So I know my distance is about 25 miles at pretty much 90% full speed. I'm gonna probably do 25-30 miles today. I'm feeling like 15 miles an hour, which kind of sucks going so slow. I think the speed limit on these trails are like 15 anyway. Thank you. taking a little detour right now. I used to fish here when I was a kid. So this is the beginning of the Platte River. I think. Smells like fish. I'm gonna do this trail another time. Miles into this, still full battery. Not sure what the rules are out here for electric bikes, so every now and then I try and look like I'm actually pedaling. That lake looks so crowded. There's no way you'd catch me out in that. That's ridiculous. All right, so when I got here, I was at about 14, what is it, 14.6 or something like that, I think. So the battery's still full, nothing's hot. I mean, it's pretty much all downhill the whole way here. It's like a 1,000-foot drop. So going back is gonna be a whole other story. And I gotta cross some railroad tracks up here. It's not such an easy cruise. But yeah, you can see, if you look over here, you can see downtown Denver. That's where I plan on going one of these days, soon. Just to see if my bike can make it actually downtown and back home. Once I get out of my neighborhood, it's pretty much flat the whole way there, and the speed limit's like 10 to 15 miles an hour. So it shouldn't be too hard on the battery. I should be able to make it there and back, as long as I just don't floor it. Kind of like right now, you know, I'm at least at 15 mile mark and battery is still showing really full. So I should be fine. All right. Somewhere you can buy a beer down there. I don't know where it is though. And I'd like to have a beer right now, but I'll just wait till I get home. I didn't record the first part right here, which was pretty hairy, but I made it. I'm heading down. I've never been down this trail, so I'm not really sure which way to go when I get here. If I have cell phone reception out here, which I think I do, I'll find my way. Mud?
Mud.
Oh, thanks. Damn. Do I want to do this? Reservoir's full. Alright guys, change of plans. Seriously. What do you do? These guys look like they went through it. Alright, go for it.
Oh man.
Why not, right? You gotta live a little. Get wet, you get wet. Halfway. Don't get stuck. Don't get stuck. I'm ready to punch it. All right. Made it. Yeah, this is really full. Gnats everywhere. Lights underwater back there. just got higher. Wow. That's why you have electric. Because when it's high like that, your feet don't get wet. So I'm over 20 miles at this point for the day, and my battery hopefully is holding out. Looks like it is. Should have brought a meter to see where I was at. So I gotta get home now to cook dinner for Father's Day. Grill out a little bit. All right, so now I'm coming up on that big hill. I gotta climb back up. Obviously it's not gonna climb it, so I gotta walk it up across the tracks. Fun. Bike weighs 72 pounds, so it's gonna be a little hairy to get up this thing. Let's see, this guy is manhandling the hill. Touch the throttle and just wants to go. Maybe I can pedal. Oh yeah, that is why I don't get off the trail. Train no whammies. Alright guys, so I'm just going to stay at about 15 miles an hour. I got about 7 or 8 miles to get home. And then I'll be over, I'll have to calculate all the miles because I've turned the bike off a few times. But since I left the little air park down there, I've gone about 4 miles. So it's not a speed race on this one, it's just a, just kind of a cruise to see how far I can go. And then I'm gonna do a measurement when I get home for the voltage, see what's left over.